multiple PVD induction manuals in simple diabetic vitrectomy. PVD induction in diabetic vitrectomy is different and difficult as compared to routine cases. Why and what are the challenges? So, the first challenge is in post-PRP eyes, where the posterior hyoid is tightly adherent to the retina. Second, taut posterior hyoid has multiple focal attachments in form of vascular and fibrous epicenters. Third, vitrocytosis, that is, splitting of the posterior cortical vitreous into multiple sheets, which is seen in many diabetics, poses a difficulty in identification of posterior hyoid. Case 1 is a 53-year-old diabetic female who had received PRP in both the eyes 6 months back. She came with complaint of recent onset defective vision in right eye with best corrected visual acuity of 636. Fundus examination showed laser marks with full thickness macular hole. In this case, using forceps, the raised hyoid was held at the disc and PVD was induced gently. This method is safer and gives better control in cases of post-lasered eyes where the posterior hyoid is adherent. Second case is 70 years old diabetic female with defective vision in both eyes since 2 months. The best corrected visual acuity in right eye was 660. Fundus examination showed PDR with vitromacular traction. Here, the taut posterior hyoid is seen as a glycerin reflex. PVD is induced by making an opening in the posterior hyoid using a spatula. Since taut posterior hyoid has focal adhesions to underlying retina, use of high suction for PVD induction can lead to break formation. So, this is a safer technique in such cases. Postoperative OCT shows release of VMT. Last is a case of combined RD with vitrocytosis. Inducing PVD in combined RD is a challenge because there are tight focal attachment of hyoid to the underlying mobile retina, unlike in RRD. In this case, tricot was used to stain the outer layer of cytic cavity. On removal of the outer layer, the inner layer, which is the true posterior hyoid, was exposed. After the exposure of posterior hyoid, PVD was gently induced using forceps. The direction of PVD induction with forceps was along the area of least resistance. With this video, we displayed certain surgical manuals for safe separation of posterior hyoid from the underlying retina in different scenarios of diabetic vitrectomy.